Remy Beadle has brought along another selection of those home video outtakes.
Don't flare up, or I'll have you all thrown into the city jail. Go on, move! Go on! Go on!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jeremy Beadle.
Thank you. Hi, and a very, very warm welcome to You've Been Framed, the show that celebrates all the unexpected comedy you've captured on your camcorders. We've got a fantastic collection of clips to share with you tonight. So without further ado, let's start the party.
You grab that one, guy. I know you got around the other side.
Okay, here we go. Well, happy birthday, Matt.
People often ask us, what's the secret of the success of You've Been Framed? Well, the truth is, there is no secret. And to prove it, here's the You've Been Framed guide to You've Been Framed. Carry your camcorder everywhere. You never know when you might stumble onto a real winner. Be brave, get close to the action, and stay with it. The most dignified occasions can create first-class comedy. Even the smallest things, like spaghetti, can create the biggest laughs. Be a star maker. Would-be stars wouldn't be stars without your camcorders. Remember, we always ask you to park your video at the funny moment. Some of you do it accidentally. Once we've seen what you've shot, we promise to return it. If we use your clip, you'll be laughing all the way to the bank. Laughing all the way to the bank, because we'll give you £250 if we use your funny home video. And you can send it to us free of charge, and we'll be giving you the details later. But I suppose the real secret of You Being Framed is laughter when you least expect it. But sometimes you can laugh just as much if you know what's coming, if you catch my drift.
Go on, move out of the way on this one. What's this one?
Star Alan Wasney and the contributor Graham Roberts. Now, Alan, what exactly were you trying to do?
I was just trying to clear the snow off the roof.
Well, but you must have known what was going to happen.
Obviously, I didn't, but everyone else did because they were watching me doing it at the time.
Listen, thank you so much. But I think you'll agree, ladies and gentlemen, that really was a cool performance. But as we've seen time and time again on You Being Framed, when you point a camcorder at a man, the chances are he's going to show off. Is that right? It's nice that the girls agree, isn't it? But at what age does this posing begin? Well, I've got to tell you, no matter how old they are, boys will be boys.
Right, go then. Da, 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 da. It's stuntman James Horsepool.
Hold the door. That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's the star and contributor of that clip, John Balchans, and the chap who shot it, Stephen Smith. John, did you mend the fence?
Yeah, it took about half an hour, but we eventually mended it.
So nobody knew?
No.
They do now, but thank you very much indeed. We've shown you the risks of taking part in sport, and earlier we showed you the dangers of being a cameraman. Now it's time to show you the hazards of being a spectator. Real football fans like to get close to the action. The young spectator at the front is having a whale of a time. The first rule of football, always keep your eye on the ball, especially if you're a spectator. The spectator in the white shirt is engrossed. He knows someone's got to take a fall, sumo or later. Golden rule, if you're going to watch motor racing from a hillside, don't stand on the left. That cameraman was obviously proud of capturing that dramatic crash, but I bet it wasn't until later that he realised he'd also captured a comedy classic. And I'm sure some of you have got hidden gems in your home videos. As brief as they might be, rewind to the funny moment and fast-forward them to us, free of charge. You don't even have to buy a stamp. Just pop the tape into an envelope and send it to You've Been Framed, Free Post, P.O. Box 450, Manchester, M60, 1FZ. And I'll be repeating that address later, so getting a clip on the show can be as easy as 1, 2, 3.
Oh, get on with it, Pave.
Three up, come on.
Turn round! Turn round!
Practice, here we go.
Jump on, jump on.
Go! Hooray! And the next one, hooray! Hooray, that's what we want.
Splitting slip-ups in part two, but just before the break, here's a tennis player serving up a drop shot.
£25,000 playing You Sum Bingo.
Count it.
And what about you, mate?
A car.
I spend it on me.
It's the big one. You Sum Bingo. £25,000 to win every week.
I can go all around the world. Somewhere else.
No other paper pays out more. Plus new lucky numbers for loads more instant prizes.
Super.
Britain's biggest bingo card. Free inside tomorrow's sun.
I'll probably go straight. For a bit. You want to buy a watch?
One-ah! Two-ah! Three?
What am I bid? One, two, three. Three? Three.
One, two, three?
Everyday life, your clothes pick up grime and smells. Phew, the traffic. Eating out. Working out. Whew, the kind of greasy dirt that can cause stale odours. You need Radian Micro. Unbeatable on dirt and odours. Radian Micro. Every day on everything. Now, that's as clean and fresh as your clothes can get.
Natrel Plus. Natural protection.
I'll get the mustard for the bangers and mash, he said. I'll do with a walk. Walk? More like a pint. Oh, Kel Surprise. We're going back the scenic way. Here we go, then. Well, the pulling power of bangers and mash and a dollop of mustard.
The English mustard. By George, it's Coleman's.
Hi.
Laura.
You always did stay up late.
How long have you been back?
About a day and a half. I was just passing by.
At this time of night?
Are you alone?
Yes. No, look, I'm expecting someone.
At this time of night?
It's a neighbour.
Well, do we have time for a coffee?
Golden roasted, richer, smoother, Nescafe Gold Blend.
If I didn't get you out of bed. This coffee tastes good. Hello.
New Sun Bingo. £25,000 to win every week.
I spend it on me.
And play lucky numbers. Get your new game card free inside the Sun tomorrow.
The Darling Buds of May, Britain's favourite programme, returns with a new member who's just
perfect.
Welcome back. And here are the contributors of that clip, Val and Charles Capini. Now, Val, who was the star of the clip?
My brother-in-law. He lives in Australia.
Australia, eh? Long way. And Charles, are you very experienced behind a camcorder?
I never touched a camera in my life. I just happened to catch that clip.
What a fantastic moment. A video hole in one. So simple that you can get gold first time. Listen, thanks again for sending in that wonderful clip starring a straw. Proof, ladies and gentlemen, that the smallest things really can provide the biggest laughs. Speaking of small things and big laughs, here are some kids at play.
Just put the racket
down your back there. The top of the bikini is going down the slide. The bottom isn't. Trying out a camcorder for the very first time, but he's so engrossed setting it up, framing the shot and thinking about something to say, that he hasn't noticed that his wife doesn't quite share his enthusiasm.
Just practicing again. I've just fixed the
Nobody knows that you're practicing.
I just fixed the handle on the video machine, and now just got it on the tripod. See how it goes. It's the video's not ours. It's Catherine printed the machine. It's a Sharp automatic focus, and we've got it for a few days, and we're just trying it out.
Here's the contributor of that clip, Robbie Robinson. Now, tell me, who was the star, Robbie?
That was my brother and his wife, out in Australia.
Another one from Australia?
Yes.
Oh, well, we do stretch out, don't we? But the wife didn't look very impressed.
Well, no, he was all very surprised about that because she's it's not like her character at all. And we were so surprised, you know, we just laughed and laughed. It was brilliant.
Absolutely marvellous, and thank you for sharing it. Of course, there are all sorts of things that can go wrong when you're making a video. I mean, there's the focusing. And, of course, the framing. And always the dreaded old camera shake. And, of course, there's the sound. Now,
sound really is one of the most
important yet overlooked things in video.
And a great deal can
go wrong with the sound. Thank you. But we professionals overcome this problem by using microphones. But you must know the correct microphone technique. Away from finding out who's going to receive £1,000 for contributing the funniest British video of tonight's show. But before that, there's one thing that this show's been missing, and we know that you love them. So here they are, animals. Gentlemen, the moment has arrived when we find out which is the funniest British clip in tonight's show. Remember, there's £1,000 for the winner, and our studio audience will choose from these three shortlisted clips.
Oh, which is my new trick?
Number one, cycling offence.
Yeah!
Number two, a sniff drink.
It's a sharp
number three, armchair critic.
And we've got it for a few days and we're just trying it out.
It's easy for me, I think they're all winners. But studio audience, which one do you think is the funniest? Audience, please vote now. And the £1,000 winner is... number three, armchair critic!
Thank you. Fantastic. Thank you. I hope you're going to cheer us on the back.
Oh, yeah.
£1,000 and £250 for sending the clip in. And of course, Robbie's clip will be in the running for the £5,000 star prize in just 2 weeks' time. But I'm afraid that's just about all we've got time for tonight. So congratulations to Robbie, a great victory. But before we leave, we feel it's our duty to present one final parade of military mayhem.
Daddy!
Let's begin by inspecting the troops. The toughest time is basic training, but this officer has every confidence in the troops behind him. On overseas tour, the first duty of every soldier is to write home. This is the modern way of doing it, on video. The soldier in the foreground is demonstrating how to use a gas mask. The soldier in the background is demonstrating how to ride a camel.
The guy tried to ride a camel in the back of the hand.
Finally, they're ready for action.
Enemy position approximately 200 meters to my front. Stop! Everybody, get down!
Cap time!
That really is all we've got time for tonight. A very big thank you to everyone who sent in a clip. Please, please keep sending them in. And who knows, next time, the star of the show could be you. Good night. Please send your funny home videos, free of charge, no stamp required, to You've Been Framed, Free Post, PO Box 450, Manchester M60 1FZ. We pay £250 for every clip we use, and we promise to return all your tapes.
The next one. Hooray! Hooray, that's what we want!